of 640.
Mr. B.K. Mukherjee, Managing Director of Sesagaw, joins us live. Mr. Mukherjee, good morning. Thank you for joining us. Mr. Mukherjee, the merger of Sesagaw and Sterlite Industries has come into effect. What are the synergies and what are the benefits from this merger for your shareholders?
You see, it is like 2 plus 2 equal to 5. The whole is greater than the sums of its parts. So Sesa Sterlite, of course, the name is yet to come into existence because of the regulatory issues, but regulatory formalities. But, you know, this is the first resource major from India in the world arena. So we have had BHP, we have had Rio Tinto, we have had Vale's. Now Sesa Sterlite would become the first resource major from India, which is a country full of resources, and I think this was long overdue. So that is number one. Number two is that, of course, along with the Sesa Sterlite, such big brand, whatever benefits it comes. And of course, administratively, it will be much more stronger. Synergies in the form of administrative costs, synergies in the form of tax benefits, synergies in the form of insurance against one commodity cycles, volatility against others, and so on and so forth.
Mr. Mukherjee, just stay with us because we've now cracked below the 5200 mark as well for the Nifty, and today you've got to lap it up with the currency as well as the global market moves as well. The currency, by the way, is not just breathed 67 to the dollar. We're already seeing a tick of 67.52 to the currency, 53 now. So that really is an all-time low for the currency. The market, in any case, is reeling under pressure right now. Mr. Mukherjee, just want to get back to you because the one concern that investors and shareholders on the street have is about the total debt which has come on in the books of Sesa Sterlite, the merged entity. In your view, is it a big matter of concern?
Absolutely no, because debts do not come without any assets. It is ultimately balance sheet which balances. So that's why it is called balance sheet. I have said it earlier also. So debts comes with the assets. The world-class assets are there, and from that assets churning, the debts will be financed. There is absolutely no issue.
So what's the total debt that you would be seeing on the books of the merged entity?
I don't have the right figures, but it is in billions of dollars, that is for sure.
There is a buzz in the market that government could lift duty restrictions on iron ore export. Have you heard anything from the ministry?
It is not a question of ministry. You see, today iron ore exporting regions are banned. Like for example, Goa is matter is in Supreme Court. So Supreme Court has to first hear it out. We don't have any effective date of hearing it. So it has to hear it out, and they have to lift the ban on iron ore mining and transport. And once it happens, I think the Goa will start exporting. So for Karnataka is concerned, there is no ban by Supreme Court yet, but there is a state government had imposed a ban. But the production is so minuscule, and the demand in the domestic market of Karnataka was so high that there is no question of any exports. So there is no, actually there is no restriction from the eastern sector of export, but because of the cost factor of export duty and high railway freight, exports are going down and down.
What about Karnataka, Mr. Mukherjee? Are you on track for resuming iron ore production in Karnataka in the current quarter itself?
Yeah, that's for sure. I think we are in a very advanced stage of getting our the last regulatory approval. We are quite advanced stage, and we expect that it to happen any time now. And thereafter, we'll be able to start. And definitely in this quarter, we'll be starting production.
So Karnataka is looking okay. Goa is in problem. What is your projected output number for FY14?
Very difficult to say, but Karnataka, we have got capacity approved of 2.29 million ton against our previous approved capacity of 6 million ton. So 2.2 million ton we'll be able to do definitely this financial year. There is no issue on that. So for Goa is concerned, it is very difficult to take any guess because when the bans will be lifted by the courts and by the other regulatory authorities like Ministry of Environment and Forest and also the state government, it will depend on that.
China has stabilized, and the economic data from China of late has improved, and China is the biggest consumer of global commodities. Do you think the worst of commodity in terms of prices behind us now, and now commodity prices both locally and globally will stabilize?
I think for that matter, why China? I think all the economies are getting stabilized except for our own country. The matter of fact is that, or fact of the matter is that iron ore price is behaving in a range bound way, and that price itself is $130-140 landed cost in China of the 63 grade iron ore. Goan iron ore is basically 57-58%, so which is little above 100 right now it is moving. So this is a range bound, because the floor is Chinese marginal cost of production of their own domestic iron ore, which is around 130-140 delivered to their steel mills. So sometimes there can be blips up, sometimes there can be down, but very as we are seeing for last couple of years, it is very soon coming back to that floor level, and right now it is hovering around that price.
Mr. Mukherjee, good chatting with you. Really appreciate you taking the time out and speaking with us today. That's the view coming in on the Sesa Sterlite merger and the economics of the industry right now. Sharply lower, down a good 1.5%. In fact, we cracked below that 5200 mark as well. It is really the oil and gas pack which is sort of dangling in between a double-edged